Item number four now. Senate Marketing Company collects personal data from customers which it stores on computers. So they collect personal data. That's the context that we're looking for, right? Collects personal data. Clear. So state two possible effects of improper storage of data. Improper storage of data would be difficult to find records and loss of records. Also duplication of records, susceptible to hacking. Right, state two measures that could be used to protect data on a computer. Passwords, encryption, a firewall, install antivirus. Let's go again. Outline the function of the loop construct in computer programming. Right, so a loop repeats a set of commands until a condition is met. State two distinguishing features for each of the following types of loops: a while, and while, a repeat until. Basically, when you see this kind of question, just kind of vomit out everything you know about while loops and everything you know about repeat until loops, and hope that somewhere you get the answer that they're looking for. Because I tell you, I don't know what answer they're looking for, because I'm not too sure what they mean by distinguishing feature. What does distinguishing feature mean? So I am going to say a while loop has the condition checked at the start and will execute commands when the condition is true. A while loop has the condition checked at the start, because a while will be like while c is equal to 2, do, and then it will follow all the commands, and then it will repeat it over and over based on the condition being true at the start. So the condition being true is that a repeat until checks the condition at the end and the commands are run at least once before the check happens. Basically runs all these commands and then it says until c is equal to 2. So this checks at the end, so these commands always get a chance to run, but these commands here may not get a chance to run because the condition may stop it at the start. You are hired by a programmer, Senate Marketing Company, to write a pseudocode for a supermarket to do what, right? So you have to prompt the cashier to enter the price and quantity of items, calculate discount amount of 5%. Oh god, look at cake. I always teach people to write algorithms with names and all kind of things. So algorithm to find total and discount. Variables, the variables that you're gonna need here, we'll write any variables after. So don't waste time. Alright, then we have start and stop. So start. Alright. So prompt the cashier to enter the price and quantity of items. So we're going on print. I like to use print, but you could put write or whatever. So print, enter the price and quantity, and then we're going to read P and Q, right? So therefore we have to have the variables P and Q for sure. Yeah, calculate discount amount at 5% if the total is greater than 500. So we have to find out the total now. So we have to create a variable T for total. T is equal to P multiply by Q, right? Price multiply by quantity. And then we have to say, if total is greater than 500, then the discount is 5%. So we have to create a D now, D for discount. D is equal to T multiplied by 5%. And then otherwise calculate the amount of at 10%. So else, D for discount is equal to T multiplied by 10%, right? Because it said if the total is greater than 50, do that. You see this word here, otherwise. Otherwise is another word for else. Else, calculate discount, total percent. And the algorithm should output the total and discount. So then, no, we had to end the if. And then, well, we are space, so we can skip a line and be like print. The total is T. And print the discount is, put those things in quotes, because it will just show that you're separating the variable. Here, isn't it? 10 marks. Write the pseudocode using nested if statements to do the following. If the mark entered is greater than or equal to 70, then display the statement grade A. So, let's break it down as they say. Let's do this first part here. If mark is greater than or equal to 70, then display grade A. Then display the statement grade A, right? Good. So we deal with that. Otherwise, if the mark is entered is greater than or equal to 60, then display the statement grade B. Otherwise is another word for else. So we just gonna put else. But it's a nested if, and this is where you're going to earn your money. Else, if M is greater than or equal to 60, then display, but you gotta make sure you indent it, then display grade B. And then now the else here for this one, else display grade not available. And then you have to end this if here, and then end this if here. That is where the nested if comes in, because what you really have is you have an else and an if inside here and a new else. But this if and this else, they are governed only inside this else. And that is what nested ifs check for. That's the 5 questions there.